So apparently there are a lot of people on the internet who get turned on by giants. Let's see how you handle this.
I said certified freak, 7 days a week. Wet ass pussy, make that pull-out game weak.
Been trying to get myself into macrophilia. I've always had an emotional fascination, and having a fetish that actually produces content would be nice, right?
Macrophilia.
That's not the
so
definition
macrophilia
of...
is the name of another fetish.
Okay.
Yeah. Can you tell me what that fetish is?
Macro.
Counting your macros before every meal.
Maybe.
Macrophilia.
Nothing to do with computers, Matt. Computers.
Yeah, I was going
to
go there. Yeah.
I don't know. Something not inflating. Something getting bigger.
You're
maybe?
Awfully close with that one. So a macrophilia is an increasingly popular sexual paraphilia.
Inflation.
In which individuals derive sexual arousal from fascination with giants.
Ah, there we go. Now, I was on the right track.
Very close, yeah. So something such as shrinking down themselves so that they are smaller than a regular person, or having a regular or someone else
bigger.
Becoming much taller and themselves remaining unchanged.
Wait, so how does well, I don't understand.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? Is like someone gets bigger, smaller? I don't understand.
Oh yeah, how would they act out that?
How do they do that?
That's the thing.
Yeah.
Let me tell you how, but
long ago, we were big and strong, in the size of flaming gold. rub my lamp, bitch.
Your wish is my command.
Oh, yeah. That's the spot. There, right. Ha, ha, ha.
So now I kind of want to go back to macrophilia.
Mm-hmm. Which yeah, I'm intrigued by this.
Yeah,
one.
Yeah. Have you ever, has there ever been a giant that you've been like, okay, damn, that's not bad?
Not really. I don't consume much giant media.
Yeah. I haven't had a lot of exposure to giants. No.
I can't think of a terribly attractive giant.
Yeah. I was turned on by Gulliver's Travels.
I don't even remember that. Not that
the,
just sounds
not the Jack
so
Black movie, the book.
Oh, the book. Okay.
Before I knew what the birds and the bees were about, there's a book in the scene where apparently Gulliver must fucking get into it with a fellow giantess.
You didn't read the source material?
Yeah, I did. I did everything else but read Gulliver's Travels. First time I had a good tingling feeling was when I was watching Tom and Jerry.
Wait, for what fetish? Oh, for the giant fetish.
Yeah.
That makes sense, like, because there's quite a size imbalance.
Because of the Tom.
Okay.
Is really? Tom the cat? Because
of the Tom. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Because Tom's a bit bigger.
Oh, and also.
And stand on the cat. The mouse
and
or whatever.
Also, the any people that are in that show, you wouldn't see their heads. So, like, in the frame, they would look big as well. Yeah.
Really? Oh, I don't remember that.
Where, like, obviously, in terms of scale, they would look big in the shot
or in
the drawing, but relative to the cat or the mouse, they wouldn't actually be that big.
Which was pretty common for a lot of shows, like Cow and Chicken, was that the same?
Yeah.
It was literally a lot of like miniature figurines, and they would put them in jars, and like it would be like low, wide angle.
Little miniature things? Or?
Yeah, miniature figurines and stuff like that.
Man, I'm going to start getting into giant.
Oh my God. 20 to 30.
$20 to $30
each. Just like the math.
Wait, is she almost like 200K a year? Is that right?
Yeah, and she gets her friends to also be giants, and there's
wow,
that's a lot of money.
Anyone wants to buy me some board games on my Amazon wish list? Some cookbooks.
You get a board game fetish, I think.
Yeah,
Catan fetish.
I wish.
Yeah.
My whole life, I just want to be inside a giant. Anyway,
a thing on the internet, and it's apparently growing in either popularity. Yeah, it's getting big. Searches for the term rose almost 1,100% since last year. Wow. The idea of being crushed or eaten or overwhelmed or consumed seems to be sort of a running thread through a lot, but not all of this. The idea that you want to be sort of at the mercy of this gigantic figure. Now, there's a couple different communities in this. It's a realm of fantasy around very big and very small people. Some, known as macrophiles, fetishize the oversized. Others, known as microphiles, get off on the undersized. And the cool thing about the internet is that you can link these people together and they both get what they want.
You can't shrink yourself and you can't become a
giant. In virtual reality, you'll soon be able to.
So, well, that'll be great, but
this is non-violent, and like with all fetishes, it's not something you choose.
Yeah.
It's just that's what you like, and it's another cool thing about the internet is that you get to experience this sort of thing without going into real-world weird situations where you might be at the mercy of psychos.
I've given all a boy can give. You take my tears, and that's not nearly. No. Take my tears, and that's not nearly.
One goes on to say, I was showing my friend what types of guys that I like, and they told me that I made a size kink up. Confused, I didn't know what they meant at the time, so I searched it up and was shocked to find out that you do have a size kink. Huge muscular men for my pleasure, small men that are shrunk down.
I don't get the kink, what is it?
So it's macrophilia or microphilia, and I've heard of it.
Both.
Or both. It could be either. Macrophilia is when you see like, bigger, or microphilia, like, think Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, where you get super, super small. This is the epitome of power exchange. Like in the 50-foot woman movie, like she's powerful, she's big. Lots of people got kinks from that. Whereas in the microphilia, it's almost like an Ant-Man.
Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're kind of like this minuscule, microscopic little bean where someone, like someone's like super tiny, like you can manhandle them and like do whatever they want again against their will.
Or Gulliver's Travels, where he was literally tied down by tiny little people.
Yep, people are into that as
That's
well.
Hot.
I've actually seen a kink.com film that was kind of like that.
Oh yeah?
That was interesting.
Yeah.
It did things for me. Or if it just kind of revolves around muscle and not just stature in general, it could be like a himbo fetish sort of thing. We're like
himbo.
Big, dumb, muscly, sexy,
blah, blah, blah.
Him, minus his shirt.
Ha.
If I just say words, will you make sounds?
Huh.
But size kink, again, is absolutely a thing that you see in all sorts of media, cartoons, pop culture. It's a trope.
You're a trope.
Thanks.
You wanna go on the day of sound? You won't get none.
Definitely use a drink. Let me go ahead and relax on our couch. You know, it's been quite an unusual last 2 weeks for me. know that I've always have had big feet. I mean, all the kids used to make fun of me in gym class. But you know what? I feel like they've started to grow, which is very strange. I mean, I would have thought I would stop growing. Oh, I don't know, about 7 years ago. But it's really been drastic enough for me to feel how tight my shoes have gotten. So I went ahead, gone to my favorite shoe store, and I guess you can say upgraded to a bigger size. But now that pair is getting tighter and tighter every single day. It's crazy. I even noticed one morning I felt a little...